Greetings, my friends. Do you ever wonder why the church is 99% dead and 99% of Christians are dead, and why fewer and fewer are coming to Christ, and why fewer and fewer Christians even act Christ-like? Here's a disclaimer. The examples I'm giving you are not my words. They are not my words. They are just examples. I am telling you what people hear. This is not me saying these things, so don't come and try to say that I'm saying things against the Lord. I'm telling you what Christians hear, and which is why things are how they are now. When babes in Christ, watered down Christians, and those seeking Christ run across these and the endless other heretical, blasphemous, false teachers, is it any wonder that they're 99% spiritually dead, along with the rest of today's saltless, powerless, so-called church? And again, here is a few examples. I'm not going to name any names. I'm going to give you examples. Many of them will be known to you, but I'm putting them out because you need to know the truth, and need to know what people who are seeking Christ, the watered down backsliders, and the babes in Christ with zero discernment hear when they go to these websites. So here's the first one. What? Are you serious? And you'll hear that screamed over and over and over again throughout the videos. You'll hear this person telling you about all kinds of wild, outlandish things that they found in the news, where if you look at them, the vast majority of them are untrue. This is a guy who supports a guy who says that the Old Testament of the Bible was written by the devil. This is a guy who supports people that lie and claim that they are secret agent men and spies from around the world, and they are just phonies and frauds. This is a guy who says that communion can save your soul, forgive you of sins, and can heal you. This is a guy who has all kinds of fake things happening, a big fake parlor trick that he had with the flying crucifix several years ago. This is a guy who, first of all, claimed to be a devout Christian, and he shows himself as a Catholic, but then says that he's non-denominational now. This is a guy who, even in his description of his channel, one of the last things he says he does is religion. And again, it's just religion. New Age is a religion. Wiccan is a religion. Demonism is a religion. So again, people go and flock to this guy and love to go to his channel, and he's constantly begging for money, constantly saying, you want to buy my book? You want to buy my CD? You want to buy my DVD? You want to do this? He's got PayPal buttons everywhere on his websites. Christians come there and hear this, and you wonder why they don't find Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Next, this woman, this Jezebel spirit-filled woman, Satan's evangelist, comes out and just begs for your money constantly, tells you how she needs to have this seed sown, and plays the real soft, heart-tugging music in the background while she's sitting there begging for your money. And she teaches false gospel. She laughs at God and Jesus Christ over the pre-tribulation harpazo and mocks them. She says things that implying that God himself is stupid. She says things cursing in God's name. She does fake biblical tongues where she could be blaspheming God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit with those fake tongues. She is a bigot. She is a hate monger who uses the F-A-G with the other three letters to it. I won't repeat it. It's too vile. I had to put it in one video when she said it. I won't say it again. She uses that word, and her husband does, and they do it with glee and laughing like it's really funny. And again, she gives you all kinds of fake fraud stuff off of the internet. Most of it's not true, and she'll also sell you all kinds of things too. What is a Christian going to learn by going to a popular site like that? Then you've got a guy who used to, I don't know, I haven't watched him in years and years, he used to actually beg you for money to pay his rent, to pay his utilities, to pay his car note, to pay for his internet. He'll sing you a little song, speaks in a real effeminate voice because he knows women like that, and that's what most of his donators are, his donors. And he'll offer to sell you a CD or a DVD or play your little song on his guitar. And he'll give you false prophecies year in and year out, reload the next year. He'll tell you he has the most definitive answer as to what the harpazo will be. And every year it's wrong. And this is the person that people flock to. And they hear lies that aren't even biblical. How are they going to find Jesus or stay with him listening to people like this? Then you've got a guy who claims he is a fallen angel in a human body. He claims that he can find magazines, he can find newspapers, money, maybe even a Pokemon card, I don't know. He can find out tell you the whole, he's a fortune teller. He's a diviner. And the Bible tells you what happens to diviners. Look it up yourself. And this guy just walks around and tugs on his shirt and pulls on his shirt and tells you that the archangel is the one that saved his soul. And he'll tell you all kinds of outlandish stories. And again, he prophesies falsely all the time. He won't preach the truth. And people flock to this guy. How are they going to find Jesus Christ through someone like this? Then you've got his sidekick, another guy who tells you, I look for things, I find things. And he's another guy that tells you about money and looks at money and tries to tell you, or magazines or different articles or cartoons, and tries to tell you he can predict the whole world by looking at this stuff. He's a diviner. Divination, God said all diviners will die. That's God's word. Look it up yourself and find out. This guy is very popular as well. He's just like the guy I mentioned before. Then you got my buddy, who I've been calling out lately, who said that God said that giving money to him, is equal in God's eyes to his son, Jesus Christ, dying and suffering and bleeding on the cross. That's what he says, and it's out there for proof. He also says that all you have to do, just like the first guy I mentioned, all you have to do is take communion every day. It forgives you of your sins. It can save your soul. It can bless you financially, bless you physically, blah, 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 blah. And he tries to show you, since he loves Israel so much, tries to bait you in, because we're all supposed to love Israel. And that's how he baits you into his trap. Then you got another guy who called out the guy that I just told you about. And he calls him out and tells him he's a false teacher and a false prophet. But this guy, little old preacher from Missouri, this is the guy who teaches lies out of the Bible. He teaches lies about the harpazo. He teaches lies about salvation, teaches lies about all kinds of things. But he's just a jolly old guy, and he comes up there and just tells you, you know, real sad stories and pity stories. And he's got a little tiny church out in Missouri, and people love him. But what are they learning about Jesus from guys like this? Then you got a couple of little small timers. I want to throw them in there as well, because you have to add a little small fry. The first ones were big potatoes. These were small fry. You got a guy who is kind of like Smokey the Bandit. And don't tell him he looks like Ahmadinejad from Iran, because he'll get really mad at you if you do. But this guy is a real piece of work too. Puts out all kinds of videos with all kinds of fake, ridiculous, goofy graphics. Lies all the time, fixated on several other guys I've had on here. Fixated on them. Fixated on me as well. Constantly says that we lie because we preach the truth of the Bible, saying that we lie about salvation, saying that we lie about any and all things he can possibly come up with. And this is another guy who's teaching another gospel, and a false gospel, has a lot smaller following, but still, those few thousand that follow him, he's leading them to hell. And if somebody leads even one to hell, it's terrible. And last but not least, my old buddy, who will sit there and tell you all kinds of sad stories, how he needs money for his homeless ministry, while he's drinking designer coffee. He'll tell you he doesn't have money for this or that, while he's spending money and begging for money for homes and cars and for any other thing possible under the sun. He'll tell you how he'll kick your butt. He's a black belt in karate, and he's the toughest guy on earth, tough as nails, and just show you things like unicorns, a unicorn lair found somewhere, or a leprechaun found at the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. That's the kind of stuff this guy preaches, calls himself a preacher. And people come to him. Again, they don't flock to him. He's one of the small fries. But again, he's got a few thousand who follow him, and that's more than need to be. But again, I thank God his videos don't get that many views. But still, the word gets out there, and it's terrible, because how is somebody learning about Jesus Christ going to someone like this? All of these false preachers, teachers, watchmen, evangelists, whatever they call themselves, they are going to answer to God at the great white throne judgment if they don't repent of their sins, turn around, ask for forgiveness, and come back to Jesus Christ right now. Jesus isn't playing games. He's not fooling around. And it's not just them who are going to pay the eternal price of being cast into the lake of fire forever if they don't change. But those of you who follow them, you won't be held unaccountable, my friends. Your blood is going to be on your own hands as well as their heads for leading you astray. It's time right now to get right with the Lord, stop believing lies, stop teaching lies, and settle it before your time runs out. I'm telling you right now, you need to figure it out and get it right. And before anybody gets mad at me about my towel behind me in the window, it's a towel that I got from my hometown. It's a beach towel, so don't try to say anything crazy about the towel I have to block the sunlight behind my window. So the bottom line is this. I've got a prayer, and I've got six vital next steps in the box below the video title. If you've never been saved or you're a backslider, if you're one of those ones that I mentioned, you better pray the prayer now. If you're following them, you better pray it now. You better repent before your time runs out, because if not, again, I've told you what your eternity is going to be. I don't care what you believe. I'm telling you what the Bible says. Time is short. You better get it right now. If you'd like me to pray for you for anything, contact me in private, and I'll pray for you in private every day. Remember, Christians, we are seed planters. We witness, pray, walk away. The rest is up to the Lord then. But true Christians, look up, my friends. Our redemption draweth nigh. We fly soon. Please share this word with everybody you possibly can. And again, if you feel guilty from hearing this video, you need to repent. If you think this video is about you, you need to repent, because the Holy Spirit's tugging at your heart, maybe for the last chance. Repent, heathen, before you run out of time. Bye.